Hey guys, Alex from 7th Hour Films back again with My Hero Academia. Last time on My Hero Academia, we had That Which Is Inherited, where basically the fifth and final match of the joint training arc went underway, and Midoriya was facing Monoma, and Monoma pissed him off, and Deku unlocked a new quirk, Black Whip. Although, I guess new is sort of relative. Technically, it's not... Well, it's new to him, but it's actually the quirk of one of his one-for-all predecessors, which is actually crazy. We don't know his predecessor's name, but it was the big Hellboy-looking dude who was, like, super buff and, like, had a jacket and no shirt. It was awesome. And he was a really cool dude, actually. But Black Whip started going out of control. And then they had to hypnotize him with Shinso in order to get him to stop. And the predecessor was like, dude, don't get angry. What are you doing? You gotta control this man. And then basically both teams are just now in a free-for-all slugfest. Like none of this whole, you know, we gotta go around and get all the individuals. Like, no, this is a 4v5 right here, right now. We're going. So, it is an all-out battle. Aizawa is not stopping the match, as it seems Deku is getting things under control, and they're just going to keep an eye on things, but All Might is freaking the fuck out, because what the hell? And we'll just take bets and say Bakugo's going to be pissed about this in some form or another, so yeah. Like always, the reaction is down in the description and in the pinned comment for your viewing pleasure. So let's go ahead and get right on to episode this one. That sentence fell apart. I wanted to say like 8 different things. Let's move on to this episode of My Hero Academia. Here we go. Okay, so... So the explanation that Midoriya gave is, I'll fucking know. When in doubt, say you don't know. If you don't know, you don't know it. Problem is, he did know it. He's gonna have to tell All Might. He's definitely gonna have to tell Bakugo. But that's the explanation he's giving. It's just, I'm not really sure what happened. I wasn't really sure what happened, but then I got it under control. And I still don't know what it is. Like, all right. But I mean, that's the thing, is that this is a huge thing with One For All in front of everybody, you know? Everybody. All right. So... The first thing I wrote down is fight quirkless, which is not what happened. So that's what Uraraka was thinking he was going to do, was try to fight without using his quirk at all. But I like how he did that, where he had Uraraka float him up there so that he could focus on his new power instead of activating full cowling and going up there and then trying to do the new power, doing Black Whip. He just focused on Black Whip, which was good. However, I almost feel like that backfired on him, because the whole purpose of full cowling is to manage his power output. So if he... Now, granted, I guess he was jumping around... He must have had it at 20 specifically, but 20 was too much for Black Whip. He couldn't use Black Whip fully at 20%, which is interesting. So then he dialed One For All back to 8%, which he knows he can fully control, and then he stopped using Black Whip, which is interesting. So... And it's also interesting, he says, you know, I'm not going to be able to fully use Black Whip until I master One For All. Well, buddy, you're only on 20. So it's going to be a long fucking time before you can truly use Black Whip then. So. You know what I just realized? There was not a single line from Ida. Or I guess even Todoroki about Midoriya and Black Whip. Like, it would cut over to, like, Jiro and Kirishima and everyone. And it also cut over to Bakugo, obviously, who recognizes it as a new quirk. But it's interesting, like, I don't think they ever, like, cut over to Ida. And maybe that sounds, like, kind of weird, like, oh, why am I specifically want Ida? But I don't know, I just wanted to hear Ida's and Todoroki's reactions to it. So, I don't know, we didn't really see them, but yeah. So that was interesting, sort of, you know, pretty much, you know, within minutes of unlocking a brand new quirk, Midoriya's already working on controlling it, and kind of doing it. Kinda. It was enough to basically block those two pipes that Shinso threw at him, which was interesting. So I like that. That was very, very good. Excuse me. So, that was really, really good. Basically just showing Midoriya's brain running like crazy immediately, like just him, his mind is just so good and so quick, and he can think of so many interesting things that he immediately tries controlling it, and it somewhat works. It does slightly backfire on him, but with every variable that he knew about, which wasn't very many, he was able to control Black Whip for a moment, you know? So that was very clever. It's just that then the new variable basically cropped up and he couldn't sustain Black Whip. So that was interesting. The subtitles, by the way, they specifically called the predecessor, the Black Whip predecessor, the fifth wielder. I should like write these down. So when we had the lineup in Midoriya's dream, we had Midoriya, then Shimura, then this guy. But that actually means that he is not the person that passed it on to Nana Shimura. He passed it on to the person that then passed it on to Nana Shimura. So that's pretty interesting. So I feel like I almost need to write this down. So I want to write this down, but am I ever going to remember to come back to this note? I don't know. Do I even have enough space? I've got to have 9 spaces. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. We'll do it here. So, number 1. We'll put AFOY for younger. We don't really know his name. So, then we have number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5. Which, shit, I guess we still don't even know his name, so I don't know what the fuck I'm going to be writing. This is going wrong, so. Number 6, we don't know. Number 7. Nana Shimura. Quirk unknown at this point. Number 8. All Might. Number 9. Is Deku. So, for number 5, for now, we'll just put his quirk, Black Whip. Okay. We'll put his name later. So far, we have 4 known... No, we have 5 known users. The original, All For One's little brother, whose name we don't know. Then we have number 5. We don't know his name. We don't know his name, or his hero name, for that matter. But we know... his quirk was Black Whip. We have number 7, Nana Shimura. We don't know her hero name. Like, we don't know if she ever used a hero name, but her name, Nana Shimura, we don't know her quirk specifically. Then All Might. We know both his names. All Might, Toshinori Yagi, quirkless. Then number 9 is Izuku Midoriya, Deku, also quirkless. So... Okay, so that is our current list. I will attempt to come back to this note when we get more information. Hopefully we will get enough information about pretty much all of them, you know? I want to see them all, man. I want to see them all. I want more of Shimura, maybe the most. Because All Might, I mean, we've seen stuff with All Might's past. It would be cool to see more, but we know enough, I feel, of All Might's past to sort of get by with this show. I want to know more about Shimura. The most we know was that she was married to a who I can only assume is a very lucky man. All right, I'll stop with my Shimura simping. I'll move on. We know that she was married and that her husband was killed, and she had at least one kid. That after her husband was killed, she put the kid into a foster home because she was afraid of what would happen if All For One, you know, went after the kid. And then then we don't really have too many connections. We just know that kid grows up and has a son, Tanko Shimura. And then some fucking tragedy happens, presumably, and then he is found by All For One and becomes Tomura Shigaraki. So, that's all we know, basically. That's all we know with Shimura. And, obviously, she trained All Might until eventually she died and Gran Torino had to finish All Might's training, so... That's the most we know about Nana Shimura, and I want more. And it may be... And look, it's not just because she's cute. And she is cute. She's so cute. And so fucking buff. Ugh! She's... You know what? She has the body type of what I would assume a female JoJo character would be. Like, she looks like she could be a descendant of fucking Jotaro Kujo. Like, she is ripped. And she's also beautiful. And they said that, too. They said that when Midoriya was like, your master, she was so beautiful. And All Might was like, I know. Ugh. Funny. You know. We always had that joke where when we would see Midoriya's shrine to All Might, we always joke, like, bet All Might had a shrine to his predecessor. I bet he fucking... When he was a kid, I bet you he had a crush on her. I have a crush on her, and I'm not even in this universe. So. What were we talking about? The episode? Let's talk about the episode. The hell was I... Mineta can bounce. That was clever. That was very, very clever. We sort of got off on a tangent about everything. But I'll get back to the episode. Mineta bouncing around was very, very clever. It definitely reminded me a bit of Gentle Criminal, which granted he wouldn't, you know, he never encountered Gentle, but it definitely reminded me of that. You know, he strategically placed all of his balls around and then he bounces off of them, which was very, very clever. And then he used, I like him using the balls as a shield too. And then of course he did that in such a way to specifically bounce into Ashido's chest. There was one shot of Ashido that I really liked. Like, it was like super cute. I don't know. It's here's the problem. It's My Hero Academia. Pretty much all the girls are cute. You'll never find a girl that's just not cute, really. So, I mean, when you have the debate, who is the best girl on My Hero Academia? You know what? Put in the comments, who do you think is best girl? So, it's hard for me to decide. I can't say Shimura because we haven't seen enough of her. If we're talking best girl, I would either say it's Uraraka or Yayorozu. I just fucking love Yayorozu. You may start to notice a pattern here that both Yayorozu and Shimura have long black hair. Huh. It sort of gets to me. Anyway, Mineta's still a pervert. But, you know, but it worked out. And then she just chucks him at the speed of sound. So Monoma drew a blank with One for All. Now here's the thing, is that if you're copying One for All, first, that's a lot. It's a little complicated to try to think about. So presumably that wouldn't then copy Black Whip, presumably. It would copy One for All itself, the core, basically. But the core of One for All is stockpile and pass it on. Stockpile and pass it on, basically. But the quirk itself is just a stockpile. So presumably when Monoma copies it, he doesn't copy all the power that's been stockpiled over fucking, I don't know, 200 years. He just copies the ability to stockpile power. So that's the difference, you know? That's the difference, which is interesting. So he wasn't able to really get anything from One for All, which is very interesting. But yeah, so I like that. And presumably he wouldn't then copy. I mean, it makes you wonder if he copies One for All, which is he copies the core, which is stockpile and pass it on. Could Monoma then pass on One for All, and while he would lose it, the time would run out on him and he would just lose that copy, would that person then have the stockpiling quirk? Now, it'd be at its minimum because it wouldn't have all the stockpiled power, but could that be it, that he would actually pass on a copy of One for All, a permanent copy, basically? Questions for the universe. If he knew, he might... Ooh, you know what he might do? You know what he might... Like, if he knew about the ins and outs of One for All, I wonder if he could pass it on to himself. Like, he passes on the copy of his quirk to his own quirk. And so he gets a full One for All. Again, doesn't get the power, but he gets a permanent copy, basically. Ugh, questions. A lot of questions. If he touched All for One, what would he get? Would he get just one of the other quirks that All for One has, or would he get the All for One quirk? And then could he pass the copy of All for One to someone, then it's permanent in them, it runs out in him, then they pass All for One back to him, and now Monoma is All for One? Questions for the universe. Shinso has some difficulties with the cloth still. I like that flashback of him training with Aizawa. And I like how they say, you know, hey, you know, I didn't have anyone. I started this from scratch. And I like how he says, you know, I don't really invest time in hopeless cases. So he does see a lot of potential in Shinso, which I like. We also had, we're getting up there on time, so I'm going to try to jump through this a bit. We had Monoma now getting better, so he can copy a quirk for 10 minutes, and he can copy multiple quirks at a time, but he can only use one at a time. So if he, like, let's say he copied, Bakugo and Todoroki, he can't shoot fire from his left while also exploding at the same time. He could only do one quirk at a time. But he can switch back and forth between the quirks, which is interesting. So, and he can hold... I don't remember if he said he can hold four or five. He can definitely hold four quirks at the very least. But he may have also taken Shinso's brainwashing. Although, no, if he has four quirks, then that's all four of his teammates. Unless he just went and copied someone else's quirk. If he copies Ida's quirk, what does that mean for him, you know? Like, before the match started, it would have been hilarious if he was just like, ah, Kirishima, wish me luck out there. And then he just goes and he has hardening, and there you go. Brilliant, that's what I'd fucking do. I'd be a dick about that. I would take as many quirks as I could before the match started. So yeah. But he also used Twin Impact and was able to hit Midoriya even after he had already been imprisoned, which was good. So he was able to grow. But they did win in the end. Class A wins with a 3-1 victory in the joint training match, which is pretty crazy. Not as even as I thought they were going to be, but that was really good. A 3-1 victory. And I like how, you know, they go over the results and everything, and they start with Midoriya. What the fuck was that? And I like how, you know, Shinso says, like, look, I did that. It's a coincidence that it really helped Midoriya, you know? Like, I did that because it was dangerous. You know, I was just doing what Uraraka said. And I like how, you know, he says, like, it was very selfish. I was just doing that for my team, not for him. And Aizawa says, look, you don't have to master being a hero immediately. Nobody can do that except All Might, but he didn't count. I like that little moment of, like, nobody is a perfect hero except All Might, but he doesn't count. So, that was an interesting line from Aizawa. So, but yes. But Shinso has passed. So, presumably he may be transferred into the hero course. Now, there is a risk with that. With the sports festival, Aizawa said that anyone who is transferred in means that someone needs to be transferred out. Is that still going to be the case? I really hope not. I don't want anyone transferred out from our two classes, you know? So I don't know. I don't know what's going to happen, but I'm very curious. But yeah, a good episode. A very, very good episode. Good stuff with Midoriya controlling Black Whip even momentarily. Good stuff with Shinso. Good stuff with Monoma. Good stuff with me simping for Nana Shimura. Good stuff all around. Yeah. Anyway. You know, it's one of those things. It's one of those things where it's like, you know, everyone sort of has that in the back of their minds. Like, oh, what if I was in this anime or something? It's like, well, shit, if I was fucking Nana Shimura's husband, that means I'd be fucking dead. That just sucks, but meh. Wonder what he was like. I honestly wonder what kind of guy does she go for? This is stupid, but I'm gonna ask this anyway. It's like, you think he was just, was he just a dude? That'd just be hilarious if he was just a dude. It's like, what is that meme of the, like, so what you're saying is, there's a chance. Like, I want to know what kind of man she went for. Like, was he just a guy? You know what I bet it was like Bakugo's parents, where it's like, I bet it was like Bakugo's parents, where his mother was like super feisty and crazy, but his dad was just like a guy. He's just sort of the submissive of there. I'm willing to bet you that might have been that might have been the case with I guess Mr. Shimura. Is Shimura her maiden name? That's my next question. I have many questions about Nana Shimura, so yeah. So we're going to end the episode before these questions start getting weird and weird and weird. Also, you can probably hear my voice is going. I haven't really been doing videos for a little bit, so yeah. Well, I'm going to go try to slide into her DMs, and we'll see what happens next time. Next episode's episode 100. Isn't that crazy? With all that being said, I'm Alex from 7th Hour Films, and I will see you guys next time. Take care. Alright guys, thanks for watching this video, and thanks for putting up with me simping for Nana Shimura. If you want to watch more of my My Hero Academia reactions, where hopefully I don't do that too often, there's a playlist on screen. There's also another video you can go click on if you want to go click on more videos from me. I always say that weird. There's a subscribe button, there's a Patreon button, as well as other links in the description if you want to go check out any of those. See you guys next time.